Disconnect the vehicle's battery before you begin this installation. Inspect the front and rear driver's side motor mounting points on the truck. If your truck is equipped with threaded inserts, skip installing the threaded rivet nuts. Using the rivet nut installation tool and hardware provided, install a threaded rivet nut for the rear driver's side motor. Insert the rivet nut into the hole. Hold the tool with one hand and drive the bolt clockwise until it bottoms out. Repeat this process to install a rivet nut for the front driver's side motor. Install the front and rear driver's side motor linkage using two M8 flange bolts per motor. The hardware should only be hand tightened. This will allow the motor assembly to move and align easier when installing the running boards. Install the driver's side running board. Prop up the running board and align the sliding T-nuts with the slots on the front and rear motor bases. Then rotate the running board so the T-nuts drop into the slots on the base of the arms. Secure the running board to the arms using the cap screws. Now that the running board is installed, tighten the hardware on the driver's side front and rear motor assemblies. Repeat these steps to install the motor linkage assemblies and running board on the passenger side. Using the rivet nut installation tool and hardware provided, install a rivet nut for the controller bracket. If your truck is equipped with threaded inserts, skip installing the threaded rivet nuts. Insert the rivet nut into the hole. Hold the tool with one hand and drive the bolt clockwise until it bottoms out. Install the controller bracket using two M8 flange bolts and one M8 hex nut for the bottom bolt. Route the passenger side electrical harness from the controller along the frame rail of the truck. Connect the passenger side motors to the electrical harness. Plug in the two passenger side LED lights. Align the LED lights to the center of each door. Stick the LEDs to the bottom side of the rocker panel. Route the driver's side electrical harness from the controller on the passenger side to the driver's side frame rail of the vehicle. When routing the harness, keep clear of any moving parts and avoid direct contact with the exhaust system. Repeat previous wiring steps to complete driver's side. Pull the front passenger carpet back and drill a 7/16 inch hole on the plastic grommet as shown. Feed the door trigger signal wires and the disable switch wires into the cab through the hole on the plastic grommet. Route the white driver's side door trigger wire and black disable switch wires under the center console. The black wires will remain here until a later step. Continue feeding the white wire to the driver's side B-pillar. Connect the driver's side door trigger harness to the white wire that was routed under the carpet. Route the brown passenger side door trigger wire towards the passenger side B-pillar and connect to the passenger side door trigger harness. Locate the seatbelt assembly at the passenger side B-pillar and install the ground wire. This will act as a ground connection to the vehicle for the door trigger sensor. Apply a strip of masking tape on the front driver's side door using the deepest part of the latch as a reference point. Make a mark 1.5 inches below the center line of the latch. Align the top of the magnet with the 1.5 inch mark as shown and stick the magnet to the door. Apply a second strip of masking tape on the door jamb using the outer edge of the front door striker as a reference point. Make a mark 1.5 inches below the center line of the striker. Lift the bulb door seal to route the sensor wire underneath it. Align the top of the sensor with the 1.5 inch mark as shown and stick the sensor to the B-pillar. We are now on the rear driver's side door. Apply a strip of masking tape on the door jamb using the outside edge of the door detent mounting bracket as a reference point. Make a mark 4 inches below the center line of the door detent. Lift the bulb door seal to route the sensor wire underneath it. Align the top of the sensor with the 4-inch mark as shown and stick the sensor to the door jamb. Apply a second strip of masking tape on the rear driver's side door using the inner edge of the door detent as a reference point. Make a mark 4 inches below the center line of the rear door detent. Align the top edge of the magnet with the 4-inch mark as shown and stick the magnet to the door. Repeat these steps to install the passenger side door trigger sensors and magnets. Feed the disable switch wire harness below the lower dash knee panel and connect it to the black disable switch wires from the controller. Stick the disable switch next to the steering column on the lower dash knee panel. Remove the fuses from the positive and negative 12-volt power leads on the electrical harness. Route the power wires into the engine compartment. Connect the ring terminals to the battery positive and negative posts. Reconnect the battery positive and negative terminals. open and close all four doors individually to test the operation of your new Stealth Power running boards. Open the driver's side door and keep the door open. Flip the disable switch to the O or off position. This will signal the running boards to retract to the stowed position, and it will disable any further operation until the switch is flipped to the on position.